the city of Moscow, Russia, hosts a large population of free-ranging dogs. Some of them, who frequent or inhabit the subway, have attracted international attention for learning how to use the trains to commute between various locations. They also have specialized behaviors, which differentiate them from both domesticated dogs and wolves. They may live in packs, but a pack's leader will interact with other packs. The leaders are not necessarily the strongest or most dominant dog, but rather the most intelligent, and are acknowledged as such by the other dogs in the pack, who depend on them for survival. One technique some dogs have for getting food is sneak up behind a person who is holding some. The dog will then bark, which sometimes startles the human enough to drop the food. The dogs have learned to cross the street with pedestrians and have been observed obeying traffic lights. Since dogs have dichromatic vision, researchers theorize that the dogs recognize other cues, such as the shapes or positions of the changing signals. The Moscow metro is the second most heavily used in the world by daily ridership, behind the Beijing subway. On average, about 500 dogs live in its stations, especially during colder months. Of these dogs, about 20 are believed to have learned how to use the system as a means of commuting. Theories to explain how they are able to correctly determine their routes included a combination of an ability to judge the length of time spent on the train in between stations, recognition of the place names announced over the train's loudspeaker, the sense of particular stations. Author Eugene Linden, a specialist in the subject of animal intelligence, believes the dog's behavior exhibits flexible, open-ended reasoning and conscious thought. The dogs have become adept to intuiting the psychology of individual humans in order to determine which techniques will work best on whom. Dogs who locate themselves in high traffic areas realize that, in such places, they often won't need to make any effort to procure food, as pedestrians will simply toss it as they pass by. Among the general human population, the dogs are simultaneously viewed affectionately and as a problem. But moreover, they are generally tolerated. Many people choose to feed them, and some people will even build basic shelters for them in the winter. They have come to be considered by many a component of the city's character. Sterilization efforts have had little effect on curtailing the population.